Bethelman, I would like to see you run again for office. We have to get some of these men out. Particularly the men who are anti-women.
Yeah.
And make laws that are so ludicrous. The question is, what's your feeling on this?
Can you believe that the contest for the presidency of the United States is going to be that personal?
Yeah.
I mean, really, how does that make us look at the rest of the world? And I would have to say that I had more women come up to me and just be totally outraged. Particularly from a group of people who say that they want part of their lives, less government, less taxes, and more freedom.
Yeah.
And they want to be in my bedroom and in the doctor's office with me? No. No. And you know what? The European people are not buying this. And particularly when the gender gap is way out of high. I'm sure Adam or whether he can tell us what the gender gap is, under 14 points. But women are not going to forget what's been going on in the Republican presidential primary. And I just, for those of you who are Republicans in the room, you better get your party straight. This is not right for America, it's not right for people, and it's not what we need to be focused on right now. We need to be focused on the economy and education and the environment and a meaningful energy policy. Those are the things that we need to be focused on. Not getting in my bedroom. I'll try to do a sweeping thing.
I'm
Linda Austin. The governor's race at some point looked like it was yours to lose, and somehow you managed to lose it. What did you learn, and what will you do differently if you run again?
Well, let's just go back and say it was never, in my opinion, it was certainly never run to lose. When Rick Scott got into the race, which was just March of the election year, and nobody in Florida had heard of him, because of course he's never done anything in Florida and had barely lived here for 7 years in Naples. My consultants called me and said, Alex, you're going to be running against him, this guy. They knew, because they knew the power of his money. And he had a very good, skilled strategic team around him. So there were a lot of headwinds in the race, we always knew it was going to be a very close, tight race. Because look at what happened to almost every other Democratic, legislator Democratic candidate all over the country. There was just a big tsunami of anti-Washington, anti-democratic sentiment, and unfortunately we thought we had a chance to overcome that, along with Rick Scott's $72 million that he put in the race with his own money. And at the end of the day, when you get outspent 2-1 and the headwinds are against you, we just weren't quite able to find those last 60,000 votes, and I'm so sorry.